Okay, now I think you can see my screen as well. So today we're gonna start the lesson that is binary logical operations. So last days we discussed about how we can convert a number between number systems in different base, like binary, octal, and hexadecimal. And again, last day we discussed mathematical operations with these numbers in number systems, other number systems. So in computer science, we're going to focus about binary number system because in computers, all the information will be communicated and processed using binary signals. So then our main focus is going to process binary signals. So in computer also what happened, normally computer use adder. Adder means addition as the main process or main operator as to process binary numbers or information in binary format. Binary formatting the information processor under computer goda kala pawichchi karana adder ekak, and the other things are comparison operators. We call them logical operators. Logical over logic ekak theernayak ganna comparison ekak. So those are the other operations types. So today in this lesson we are going to discuss about these logical operations that we gonna perform using binary numbers or information in binary number system. Okay, all right. So the basic hardware unit which is developed to process or operate this kind of a logic are called as gates. Those are the basic hardware units or smallest hardware units that we can use to take a decision, software level decision. So මේක කොහේ හරි තැනක physically සිද්ධ වෙන්න ඕන. මේ හැම දෙයක්ම අපි හිතන දෙයක් වුණත් මොනවා වුණත් කොහේ හරි තැනක physically සිද්ධ වෙන්න ඕන. Right? So then everything must have a physical basis, physical base එකක් මේ හැමෝටම තියෙන්න ඕනේ. So then in computer science the smallest physical base is these gates, you know, gates කියලා. So people who have done A level, done ICT for A level, they already know these gates, right? Others also may, because in our other lessons also in our school time we have learned them. So again we're going to refresh our minds. So there are several type of gates. Again, this note is available in LMS, right? Anyone can download from LMS. It's given in LMS. Okay. So basic logic gates are the initial ones. So those are the basics. All the other gates have been developed on top of these gates, basic logic gates. Actually, in here, what we're going to learn the logic in these gates. අපිට මෙතන ඉඳලා වැඩ ගන්නෙ මෙයාලගේ තියෙන logic එක. So initially we're going to discuss about basic logic gates. There are three basic logic gates. So basic logic gates are associative and commutative in nature. So these are the foundation of logic, which are materialized with which are developed with materials, right? Material use කරලා develop කරලා තියෙන base එක තමයි මේ gate එකක් කියලා කියන්නේ. අපිට ඒක physically දකින්න පුළුවන්. ඒකෙන් ඒ වගේම decision එකක් ගන්න පුළුවන්. තීරණයක් ගන්න පුළුවන්. So those are just theories, concepts. Those theories have been materialized using these gates. Okay? So then the first gate that we're going to discuss is AND gate. Here you can see the signal, sorry, a symbol. This is the symbol. And again, normally an AND gate can have n number of inputs. Here, these are the inputs. Here we have an input, and this one is an input, and this is the output. So in this one, this is the first input, and this is the nth input. That means we can have any number of inputs. However, again, this is the output. Okay, so you can see every gate can have multiple inputs, but again, these gates don't have only one output. So then the basic logic behind this AND gate is, if any of these inputs having a negative value, that means in binary we know that we're going to deal with only two states, 1 and 0. 1 and 0 itarai binary walli pawachchi karanne. So this is called as two state logic. Tamai wala awashya dewal note karaganna, please note down anything that you learn here. We call this two state logic. Two state logic, right? Because it has only two states, true false or yes no, like that. And again, basically we indicate that using 1 and 0, right? So in AND gate, the basic logic is, if any of the inputs going to have 0, the output will be 0. Any of the inputs going to have 0, the output will be 0. Got it? So keep in mind the logic in AND gate, that is, if any of the input is going to 0, output will be 0. So that's the logic. Right. So that is AND gate. Again, truth table. So you can see here, in this point, we have 0. And here also we have 0, 0, 0. In these three lines, in any of here, A is 0, both are 0. A is 0 and B is 0. So you can see here, when an input is 0, the output is 0. Here we have only 1, 1, then the output is 1 here. That is called the truth table. These are the inputs. Again, this is very important. This is called as time diagram. Right, this is time diagram. So here you can see, these are the inputs given. This is the input signal. So 0, 0 here and 1. This is 0. If this take this time interval, you can see 0. Here also 0. Then the output is 0. And this point, this one is 0. Therefore, here output is remain 0. And this point output is 0 because 0 is here. And here that comes to a 1. So this is called the time diagram. So that means we're going to indicate what are the signals that we're going to input. So first signal is something like this. And the second signal is this. So according to that, you should be able to draw the output signal. So here, this is the output signal, right? So if I have given you a signal, two signals, and after processing that one, you should be able to draw the output signal. So that is about AND gate. So is it clear? Everyone, I need your response. Again, every time that I'm going to set that, so if I ask that it is clear, please reply, right? Daruna, reply karana. Reply karana daru naththam mata kelima digatama karagena yanna puluwan gatuluwak naha me emath oyala tai apahasala wenna therenna natte. So I want to know that it's clear for you, oyala hari theruna kiyala em naththam prashna handa naththam mata digatama karan yanna puluwan hari. So if you are not replying, I'll continue the lesson, right? Okay. Let's go to the second gate, that is called O gate. It's actually just a very simple things. You already know these things, right? But for refresh your mind, we'll discuss. Here, this is the O gate, and this is the signal symbol you can see. So here also you can see we have two inputs. So this is the input, and this is the output. And here we have n number of inputs. So the symbol is plus. In AND gate, we can indicate A dot B. So this is AND. The dot indicates AND. This also can be written as AB. So if there is no operation signal symbol, that is also considered as AND. Here in OR gate, we use a in OR gate we use plus sign. So A plus B. So this plus indicates O, right? Okay. Again, if we go to the truth table, you can see here we have 1, 1, and 1, and all these three times the answer is or the output is 1. So then we can mention the logic in OR gate as if any input is 1. If any input is 1, the output will be 1. Ekka input ekak hari ekka wenawa na output will be 1. That is the logic behind OR gate. If any input is 1, the output will be 1, right? Again, you can see this is a time diagram for OR gate. Right. So there also you can see if we have 0, 0, 0, so output is 0. And again, 1 is there, so output is 1. Because of this 1, output has become 1. Again, because of this and this as well, the output has become 1. So the output signal is this, right? I think you can understand this one. That is called time diagram. Again, the third basic logic gate or the last basic logic gate is NOT. So in NOT gate, the theory or the logic is if we give an input, it will give the complement of that input as the output, opposite side. If we input 1, it will output 0. If it is 0 is the input, the output will be 1. That is the logic. And truth table and the time diagram. So I think you have a clear understanding about the basic three logic gates, NOT gate and gate, sorry, OR gate and NOT gate. So let's go with the calculations and questions, right? Okay. Now, I want you to AND. I'll write it here. One, zero, zero.
So we can't see, sir.
Okay, sorry. Okay, I think you can see now, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. But if you use a one, zero, one. And again, we're going to AND. Okay. If we're going to AND this one, Right, we are going to end. And right, okay. So now you can find the answer. So here you can see this should be 1. And here we have 0. So 0, 0, 0, 0, 0 and 1. This is the answer. You can note them down. If you have questions, you can ask. Okay. So let's try another. Now we're going to over this one. So then here we have 1, so output will be 1 1 1 1 1 0 1. If you already know the answer, please reply in chat. All right, so that is OR. Shall I erase this? Then I'm going to erase this as well, right? Is it okay, children? Shall I erase?
Okay, sir.
Now this is what you're going to do. Let's say A equals okay. So now what you're going to do here, if I write A right, now we have to find the output signal. So the priority will be given to this one, A and B, then OR C. Can you try? I'll give you some time. Can you try? I'm receiving different answers. Let's see.
So, if you are going to have a basic download of the Kepa,
I තනිතරම් ගැටලුවක් නැහැ දර මොකද අපි කියලිම බයිනරි මේ සිග්නල් ගැන කතා කරන නිසා හැබැයි දානවා නම් හොඳයි අත්තර ලොකු ඉෂුවක් නැහැ අපි මොකද කියලිම සිග්නල් එකක් අපි බයිනරි සිග්නල් එකක් කියලා අපි මේක ඉන්ෆෝම් කරලා කතා කරන නිසා ඒක ගැටලුවක් නැහැ මොකද අපි නම්බරයක් නෙමෙයි අත්තර සිග්නල් ප්‍රොසෙසින් ගැන අපි කතා කරන්නේ so it is okay but again දැම්ම කියලා ගැටලුවකුත් නැහැ කියන්නේ දැම්මත් දැම්මත් හොඳයි මම අපි දැන් නම්බර් අතර මේ නම්බර් එකක් මම මේ ફોકસ කරන්නේ. ඒකයි ලියන්නේ කියලා. අපි හිතමු දැන් ලෙටර් එකක් කියලා. ඉවන් ලෙටර් කැන් බී රිප්‍රසෙන්ටඩ් යූසින් so next day we going to discuss how we can represent letters and everything. So in that case this is two state binary signal. So mentioning this one is not necessary but it is okay. All right, let's see, right? So the first one is A is 1 0 1 1 1 0 1 0 1. Now A and B, right? So here we have 1 0 0 1 1 0 1 0 0. So we have to end this one. Here we gonna have 1 0. Here we have 0. That means 0 0 1 0 1 0 0. So this is the answer after we end this one, right? And what here do we have to OR with C? So C means 1 0 0 1 0 1. To our this, so here 1 0 0 1 1 1 1. This is the answer. So here we have OR this, and this point we have, and this one. Got it? So there are different answers. So if your answer is incorrect, please understand how we did that one. And if you have questions, please ask. Right. Okay, shall I rest?
Okay.
We'll go with another. Let's say A is equal to 1. So you should find this. The output of this function. When you process above signals in this way, you have to find the output. Shall we try? Okay, let's try. The sun is 1 0 1 1 1 0 1. 4 1s are there, right? Okay. Next one is 1 0. Sorry. So the first step should be this one, B plus C. So then B means 1 0 0 0 1 1 0. C means 0 0 1 1 0 0 1 1. So we have to OR this. If you are this one here, 1 1, it's also 1 1 1 1 0 1. Then we have to end this with A. 1 0 2 3 4 0 1. We have to end. Then 1 0 1 1 1 1 0. You can see again the answer, the output signal is totally similar to A, right? Again, in this time also I have received different type of answers, so please check with your answers, and if there is something wrong that you did, please correct that one. And again, if you have any thing to ask, please ask, right?
Excuse me, sir.
Hello.
අර සර් මේ two table එක මේ මේ යොදාගන්නේ ඔක අපි එකතු කරන්න ඕනේ ඒක කරන්න ඕන
truth table එකද?
ඔව් සර්.
truth table එක use කරන්න පුළුවන් දරෝ. හැබැයි මෙතන මට අවශ්‍ය වෙන්නේ මේ signal එකේ process එක විතරයි. ට්‍රුත් ටේබල් එක ගත්තොත් අපි කරන්නේ හැම සිග්නල් එකකටම හොයනවානේ.
ඔව්.
එතකොට එහෙම එහෙමත් එහෙම එහෙමත් පුළුවන්. ඒ කියන්නේ දැන් මේකෙදි A වලට අපි ABC කියවම අවස්ථා තියෙනවා කියලා 8ක් තියෙනවා. දැන් අවස්ථා 8ටම අපිට හොයන්න පුළුවන්. හැබැයි මේ කරන්න යන්නේ ඒ මේ තියෙන දැන් මෙතනත් අතර දැන් එකම අවස්ථාව දැන් මේ මේ අවස්ථා 8ක් කියන්නේ මෙහෙමනේ. මේක එක අවස්ථාවක්. ABC තුනක පිළිගැනීම. මේක තව පිළිගැනීම 0 0 0 කියන අවස්ථාව. මේක 101 කියන අවස්ථාව. ඔය ඔය ටික ඇතුලේ මේ ටික ඇත්තෙම හදනවා තමයි. බෑක් මෙතන කරන්නේ මේක සිග්නල් එකක් අල්ලගෙන ඒක කොහොමද ප්‍රොසෙස් වෙන්නේ කියන එක බලන එක තමයි කරන්නේ. හරිද? ඔව් ටේබල් එකට කරන්න පුළුවන්. හරිද දරුවෝ?
ඔව් ජස් සර්.
හරි. මයිනස් කරනවා. Next one. Say this is A. Say B is 1. These are inputs. So now I want you to draw the time diagram for processing these signals and what is the output signal. I want to know the output signal with the time diagram. So now what you have to do, you draw the time diagram here. So I divide this for we have actually 8 signals, right? So this is the time. This is T1, T2, T3, T4. So T means the time interval, right? Then call it T1, T2, T3, T4. So that can be seconds or nanoseconds, like that. That can be kind of a time interval. Again, first we have to have A. First signal. And in here, A is 1, right? 1. And then 0. This time interval also it's 0. 1. So this is the representation of signal A. Then if we take B, here it's 1. For these two time intervals, 1. Then it's going to be 0. Again, 1, 2 zeros, 1, and after that again, 0. This is B. So if we say our equation is something like this, let's say something like this. So then here we have B. And we have to find A plus B now, right? Okay. So here we have 1. A plus means OR. So this should be 1. And in second point also we have 1. So this is also 1. And here both are 0. So this has to be 0. Here we have 1, so output is 1. In both ends, both signals, we have 0. That means we are going to perform OR function. So then output will be 0. In this point, we have 1 here. According to OR function, if one thing is one signal is has 1, then the output will be 1. So it comes here. And all these three time intervals, A signal has 1. So that means the output also will be 1. So this is the output signal for A plus B. Then we have to have the C signal. So C here. C. So C is something like 0, 0. Both time intervals are 0. 1. There are 3 ones. And again 0. So this is the representation of signal C. So now we have to AND the result of A plus B, A or B with C. Then let's see. That is A plus B, C. So this is the signal that now we're going to draw. Okay, so here we have 0. So that means output will be 0. E also 0. In this point, we have 0. So output is 0. Here we have 1 in both signals. So then only AND operation can output 1. In this point, we have 0. And here we have 0 in signal C. So this is how the signal goes. And this is the output signal. So like that, you have to elaborate time diagram for signal processing. So we're going to discuss about simple AND and OR gates, NOT gates, those things. Then you should be able to draw the digital time diagram for signal processing. Is it clear now?
Yes, sir.
Others?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Any questions? So if you don't have any questions, we'll go with the exercise. Okay, these are the signals. These are signals. Now this is the processing instruction. All right. So this is the processing instruction. To make the instruction is what you have to process. Actually, I want to draw the time diagram for this signal, for this processing. It also have 8 time intervals. Then in that case, A NOT is used. So again, you have to find NOT A and you have to add that with B. So like that, you have to draw the time diagram. If you are unable to, if it is complex to draw one diagram, you can go with 2, right? You can find A dash plus B. And again, in the other type time diagram, you can find A dot C. Then you can have the final diagram. It's okay. But if it is, if you are okay with one diagram, that means that can be somewhat complex when you can draw all these signals in one diagram. But if you can use some other colors to indicate these, then that will be easier for you to understand. Just look it and understand, right? So however, I want you to draw the time diagram for this process. The process sekata time diagram ekak waladan anninna one. So I'll give you some time, please try. Please keep your microphone silent. Okay, answers are okay, but I want you to draw the time diagram. என்ன பத்தா
ஹலோ
ஓ கதா கரந்து ரோஹினம்
சரி டேஸ்டினிங் கொடுங்கினே
நோட் டேக்கர் डैश के लिए ना भी नॉट टेक नॉट गेट टेक और एक अति बहुत बिंदु है ना
ओके सर ओके
हेलो सर
ओ
मैं सी ए का पेन है सर अरे
excuse me sir
how
sir me a c a c ana piliwala maarunu ana kamanna ne sir
kamak na kamanna output ekak process karaganna lesi dihara dala This is a. Then a dash means zero, the not opposite side of that signal. This is a dash. B. Then a dash plus b orb. Orb means the logic is if one input has one or true as the input, then all the outputs will be one. If any of the inputs has one, then output will be one. So here this is one. So this is A dash plus B. Then we have to AND A with C, right? Not A dash, A with C. So here we have to compare this one and here. This is A. One. So C has zero. That means these are zero. This is, sorry, this is not seen, right? And here we have one. In this point, it goes zero again. So we have to check A in this signal, and after that, this signal, C. So here 1, 0, 0, 0, because 0 is there. Again, 1. And here we have 0. This is 0. And here we have 0. So this is also 0. Then we have to compare this signal and this one. Again, we have to AND that one. Here we have AND. If you do that, one, zero.
Excuse me, sir.
Oh,
there is a question in O operation between A bar plus B and O, not AND operation before the bracket.
Sorry, but I didn't get you.
Before the bracket, there is no AND operation, there is O operation in the question.
A bar plus B bar plus?
A bar plus B plus.
A bar plus?
B plus.
B plus.
Sorry, still I didn't get you the point.
So we pastari dala tiyanne b wedi kirima kiyanne etana plus
ka thiyanne. Ah, plus there, right, right, right. Okay. Sorry. Here, right? I'll correct that one. Yeah, it should be plus. All right. Thank you for reminding that. Okay. So if we go with this one, we have to have an OR, right? So here, one is there. And up to this point, that will be one because A dash plus B has one as a state. And here we have one, this point one, this point one, and this point is one. So signal will be this one. Right. So I have received there is a question, sir, we got to answer and draw a diagram for only answer. No, it's not okay because here, with the diagram that we're going to understand how these signals will be processed. So if you're asked to graphically represent with the time diagram, you have to draw all the inputs and outputs there in the diagram, right? The answer is not enough. Only the answer, measuring all the answer in the diagram is not enough, right? Okay. So most of you have replied the correct answer. So thank you for answering that. And again, I think you have the understanding about how we can process the signal using these basic logic gates. And again, how to represent that in a time diagram, right?
Excuse me, sir. Okay, sir. Mulimma A dot C කියන එක හොයලා ඉවරලා ඒකට පස්සේ B එකතු කරලා අන්තිමට A dash එකතු කරන එක එහෙම
කරදිද? කමක් නැහැ. වැරදි නැහැ.
Thank you, sir.
That is also okay. So while we're going to process these instructions, there are some logics. Those are called as Boolean logics, right? So we are not going to discuss those logics in here because we are just going to understand how the fundamental things in the computer works. So this is not about, so we're going to discuss those things in basic electronics, right? So this is not actually electronic subject. So that is why I'm not going to discuss the Boolean logics and everything, how you're going to shorten these instructions using Boolean logics. So those will be not these those will not be discussed here. So here what you're going to understand how these signals going to process inside a processor of the computer, right? To understand that one, just we're going to process these kind of instructions here. So actually what you must understand, this A here, this one, this can be kind of instruction. So this can be a data or an instruction. That means to bool a text, to open a file like that, that can be instruction, right? Yeah, this one also, right? This can be a data. So if you just type A or some kind of letter, that has to be displayed in the monitor. So to do that, there can be multiple instructions given to the CPU, right? So this can be those instructions. So then me varada therum gannepa api binary gana katha kara numbers convert karana widiyana katha kara. Ekaṭa me hama number ekakma me kiyana base walin naththan octal hexadecimal binary kiyana base walin represent karanna puluwan kiyana api katha kara. So in here we're going to focus about only binary representation, binary numbers. So we know that numbers can be converted into binary. So but you using these numbers, we going to convert all the instructions and data into this binary format. The computer ekatule hama data ekak meha meha yanne binary walin. Harida? So to process these things, the basic units the processor use are these gates, logic gates. So initially we discuss in the next lectures, right? So in hardware lecture that we're going to discuss the initial stages of the CPU. So in history, in CPU, they have used vacuum tubes. So using these vacuum tubes, what they could do, compare two values and give an output, just like a gate. So then what they had to do, they had to develop thousands of vacuum tubes and connect them together to perform one simple instruction. Just to add two numbers, they had to use thousands of what is called vacuum tubes, right? So like that, this is the basic process inside the CPU. So we're going to understand how these signals and instructions or data going to be processed inside the CPUs in this time diagram. So here, this time is called as the clock pulse or clock interval of the CPU, right? We're going to discuss about clock interval in hardware lesson. So all the instructions that are being sent to the CPU will be processed in these clock cycles. So here also, it is important that you understand every instruction and data will be processed in these clock cycles. So the computer samanya api on karata passe eyage weda karana CPU clock ekak. Hama thisen pulse ekak denawa. Me wage time interval ekata pulse ekak. So this time interval can be a second or nanosecond or kind of a small time duration, time interval. මේක තමයි අත්‍තරම අපි කියන්නේ processor එක speed එක කියලා. මේ time interval එක shorten වෙන්න 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 speed එක මොකද වෙන්නේ? Speed එක වැඩි වෙනවා. So every time interval this going to process or this going to calculate actually kind of a instruction which is given in binary format. CPU එකට වෙන්න එතකොට මේ වැඩේ අපි දැන් ගත්තේ මේ විදිහට instructions ටික එනවා. දැන් අපි මේ AND නම්බර වලින් මෙහෙම සම්බන්ධ කරාට මේ program එක ඇතුළෙත් අපි අත්‍තරම කරන්නේ මෙන්න මේ වගේ මේ වගේ ඉන්ස්ට්‍රක්ෂන් එකක් ලියන එක ප්‍රෝග්‍රෑම් එකක් කරන්නේ. ඒත් අපි සාමාන්‍යයෙන් print වනම්මනම් ওই වචන දැන් අපි කතා කරා just in programming lesson we discuss some keywords, right? So those algorithms can be represented in this way. Very simply. This can be an algorithm, right? A representation of an algorithm. So then that algorithm will be processed inside the CPU using this given signals, data and instruction in time interval. Clock pulse. පැහැදිලිද? So what here we going to learn? OR gate, AND gate, and their logic inside. So a combination of these one is called as a CPU, right? මේ වගේ ඒවා මිලියන ගණනක එකතුවක් තමයි CPU නැත්නම් microprocessor එක කියලා කියන්නේ. Again, children understand that there are some Boolean logic as I said earlier. So those logics are not we are not going to learn about those. We are not going to apply those logics here because we're just going to learn about how signal are processed inside the CPU. That's all, right? Okay. Kiyapu kata andare pahadili thamai me signal processing gana thamai katha karanne CPU ekata nikan basic understanding ekak gannai hadanne. Hari. Shall I erase this then? We have already discussed three logic gates. So those are AND, OR, and NAND gate, NOT gate. So those are the basic logic devices. Okay, does anyone has a question regarding things that we discuss. Okay, children. So next one, universal logic gates. That means this is a combination of NOT gate with other two logic gates, AND gate and OR gate. So those two gates are combined together. So when we combine a NOT gate with AND gate, that is called as a NAND gate. So that gives the opposite output of AND gate. So in AND gate, the logic is if any input is zero, the output will be zero. So here the NAND gate, it says the logic is if any input is zero, output will be one. That is the opposite side of NAND gate, AND gate. Got it? The logic is if any input is zero, output will be one. AND gate එකේ අපි කියනවා එකක් හරි බිඳුව වුණොත් output එක බිඳුවයි කියලා. NAND gate එකද අපි කියනවා එකක් හරි බිඳුව වුණොත් output එක එකයි කියලා. This is the symbol. You can see a circle is there in front of the NAND gate AND gate symbol that represent the NOT. මේ circle එකෙන් represent කරනවා NOT කියන එක. And again this is very important to understand. Here, this one, right? So A dash B dash, this is somewhat different. And here what we're going to have as the output is A B dash. These are two different instructions. Make kiyanne A ekak note karala B ekak note karala A deka AND karanna. Metana di kiyanne A AND B, A saha B AND karala A ke note ekak ganna. So these are two different instructions, right? You want me to understand? And again, up to n inputs, we can have n number of inputs there. So logic gate, you can see. In truth table, you can see zero is there, so output is one. Zero is here, output is one. Zero is here, output is one. One is there, no zeros, then output is zero. Time diagram. I think you can understand that. Then NOR gate. So OR gate with the NOT gate, a combination of these two. And here it is same. So if you use A dash plus B dash, and here we're going to have A plus B dash. Again, this is something different, right? Here in OR gate, we use A OR B dash or not. Yeah, this is the correct one. All right, children, so this is the truth table. You can see again the logic is right. So in OR gate, the logic is if any input has one, the output will be one. In NOR gate, the logic is if any input has one, the output will be zero. එක input එකක් හරි එක තියෙනවා නම් output එක බිඳුවයි. ඒක තමයි මෙයාගේ logic එක. And this is the truth table. Sorry, the time diagram. Shall we try with an example? Okay, let's see. A equals. Let's go with the complex one, right? Before that, let's go with the simple one. If we NAND this one, what will be the answer? Please reply in chat. Here, NAND, the logic is if any input is zero, output will be one. So here, one, zero, right? Please go with the logic. If any input is zero, output will be one. That's the logic. Okay, then after that, if we again OR this one. We are going to OR this. Know this, right? Yes. So in no, the logic is if any input is one, the output will be zero. Zero, 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 zero. Zero. If any input is one, output will be all right. So I think everyone could understand. I'm going to pass it to okay, so these are the A and B, C out inputs. We're going to find this one. Okay, I'm not going to help. Please try to find the answer. everyone try to solve the matter and reply me in chat. All right, let's see. So first one is, we have to consider is this one. A plus B dash. So if you take A. Again, B. So we have to know this one, right? Know means if any input is 1, the output will be 0. This is it. And C, 1, 1, 0. So we have to, and this one. So NAND means if any input is 0, output will be 1. This is the final output of the signal. So same, if I ask you to draw the time diagram, similar method applies. So I'm not going to draw any more time diagrams. I think you know how you can draw them. So for these instructions also, same process can be applied to draw the time diagrams. So however, what you must understand, what are you going to give to the processor are instructions, and those are represented in binary format. So A can be an instruction, or A can be data. B is an instruction, or can be data. Again, these and O also instructions. So what process do, it will compare, or it will apply these logics behind these and O gates into these instructions and data, and it will output a signal. So that signal will be sent to the relevant output devices. Okay, kids, I'll erase this. Other logic gates, XOR gate and XNOR gate. So these are the symbols, XOR gate and XNOR gate, right? So XOR, you can see, this is how we're going to indicate that one, A, like this. This is XOR. Again, if it is NXOR or XNOR, XNOR gate, we're going to apply not here. You can see this is the symbol. And when we add a circle here, that becomes no, N, not. So logic of this XOR gate is, if any inputs are equal, the output will be 0. I'll tell you that again. If any input is 0, the output will be, sorry, if any input is, again, if any of the inputs are, sorry, if all the inputs are equal, again, if all the inputs are equal, then the output will be zero. If the inputs are not equal, then output will be one. That is the logic. I'm telling again. In XOR gate, the logic is if all the inputs are equal, output will be zero. Only all the inputs are equal, the output will be zero. Equal means that can be only inputs can be zero or all the inputs can be one. So then the output will be zero. NXOR means the opposite side of that one. If all the inputs are equal, output will be one in NXOR, and XOR that will be zero. So try to understand that using these two truth tables. So if we go with the time diagrams, those are like this. Input take equal na zero. Equal na zero. Here equal na one, equal na one. Okay, so those are about gates, and those are the basic logics which you're going to use for processing in a computer. So do you have any questions regarding those? So now you should be able to solve or process instructions given in binary format according to the instructions. And or XOR, NOR, like that, those instructions are given in symbols as well, you should be able to process the output signal. Again, you should be able to represent that in as a binary code or using the time diagram as well. පාඩ දොර මෙහෙම signal keypad දීලා ඒවට දාලා instructions වලින් instruction එක ලියුවාම ඒ instruction එක වලට binary code එකක් represent කරන්නත් පුළුවන් වෙන්න ඕනි සහ මොකක්ද time diagram එකෙන් represent කරන්න පුළුවන් වෙන්නත් ඕනි. ඊට වඩා හරියට symbols දැනගෙන ඉන්න ඕනි. අපි ආයෙ මතක් කරොත් මෙහෙම ලියුවොත් මේ තියෙන්නේ and එක නේද? මෙහෙම මේ dot එක නොතිබුණත් මේක and එක. ඊට පස්සේ මෙහෙම ලියුවොත් මේ තියෙන්නේ or gate එක. A or B. මේ තියෙන්නේ NAND gate එක. මේ තියෙන්නේ NOR gate එක. This is AND. This is OR. This one is NAND. This is NOR. And this is XOR. And this is NXOR. Oh, this is called XNOR, right? XNOR. And again, if this is not. Okay, children, clear?
Yes, sir.
Others?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So now we must understand in computer, almost all the instructions will be processed using the plus operator or add operator. Computer ekata godak kala ne process siddha wenne add karne ke ekathu karne ke. So we call that an adder. There is an electronic device in computer, a very small one, that is called an adder, right? Using this adder, all the instructions will be processed. So normally subtraction, division, and multiplications, all these other three operations, mathematical operations also are going to be processed using this add operation only. මේ අනිත් කියන තුනම එකතු කිරීම sorry අඩු කිරීම බෙදීම වැඩි කිරීම කියන තුනම සිද්ධ වෙන්නේ එකතු කිරීමම පමණයි. අඩු කරන්න හැ computer එක. It always use some other kind of methods to subtract using add function, add operator, addition operator. එකතු කිරීමෙන් තමයි හැම වෙලෙම කරන්නේ. To do that, the computer use a method called complement. So in there are two concepts. One is once complement, and second, and the other, the improved one is advanced one is toast complement. Once complement and toast complement. So normally the computer use toast complement to calculate or process mathematical operations with binary codes. Binary number mathematical operations කරන්න පාවිච්චි කරන්නේ complement එක. So first, if we discuss about ones complement, it is very simple. That is the opposite side of this signal. That is ones complement. So to perform that one, there is a device called is developed in CPU. If I draw that, that is something like this. It is something like this. These are the ends. Right. So now, what we have to do here? If we give, let's take this one. So 1 0 0. 1 1 0 0 1. This is signal. So this next signal will be input from this end, from here, and then this will output 0 1 1 0 0 1 1 0. So this is called as the ones complement. Ones complement, right? මේක තමයි ones complement කියලා කියන්නේ. අපි උදේ කරන්නේ තියෙන එකේ opposite එක ගන්න එක. So this is a device which is used to process the ones complement of a signal. මේ not gate set එකක් නෝ සාමාන්‍ය 8යි පාවිච්චි වෙන්නේ. not gate 8ක් එකට combine කළා තමයි මේ basic device එක හදන්නේ. Okay, after that there's device called adder. Adder ekak pawichchi karanawa ilamata. So using that adder here, let's say we're going to add 0 1 1 0 0 1 1 0. So this is the first complement. We can add 1 for this. So then we know how to add two binary numbers 1 1 1 0 0 1 1 0. So this is the twos complement. ekak meka ekathu karada samaya tikena twos complement kiyala. All the instructions are there in the tutorial, right? Note. Okay, we'll go with another example. So children, if we have something like a signal like this one, if we need to find one's complement, then what we have to do? We have to take the opposite side of this one. So 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0. It's the first complement. Again, if we need to find the second 2's complement, then we have to add 1 for this. May OR name, this is add. එකතු කිරීම කියන ඔපරේටර් එකනේ ඈ පටල ගන්න එපා this is not or so now we going to have 1 0 0 1 1 0 this will be our output and this is the 2's complement of above signal actually if we take the decimal value of this one අපි ගත්තොත් නෑ decimal value ඉතින් කීයද 1 2 4 8 16 32 64 වමනෙන්නේ ඉතින් අපි place values ගත්තොත් 1 2 4 8 16 32 64 128 then
එකපාර අයින්ද බා මේ පොඩක් බලන්න ඇතුලේ
සතෙක් is please keep your microphones mute
make
kata mai roshan your mic is on please keep your microphones mute okay children so if we convert this decimal here we have 1 2 3 3 plus 4 7 7 plus 16 23 plus 32 2555 plus 128 183 right this is 183 and again this value is minus 183 but if we convert this into decimal what's the value 1 2 1 2 4 8 So 9 plus 64, that is 73, right? That is 73. But we consider this value as the this value as the minus value here, minus of 183. මේකට අපි කියනවා 183 minus value. So we obtain that one using the 2's complement. අපිට පටලවා ගන්න එපා. හරිද? අපි මෙහෙම නම්බරයක් අරගෙන 2's complement එකට පස්සේ අපිට ලැබෙන උත්තරය වෙන එක. ඇත්තටම ගත්තොත් මේක අපිට හම් වෙන්නේ මේ 256 අපිට හම් වෙන්නේ 256 minus 183 73 මේක තමයි හම්බලා තියෙන්නේ මෙන්න මේ process එකෙන් but we take that as minus value of 183 ඒක ඇත්තම කතාව ගත්තාම මේ තියෙන්නේ 256 minus 73 වලින් තමයි 183 හැදෙන්නේ මෙන්න මේ බයිට් එකේ ඔක්කොම එක වුණොත් මෙතනින් පෙන්වන්න පුළුවන් උපරිම numbers ගන්න 256ක් from 0 to 256 256 is the, sorry 55 නේ 255 is the largest array. Let's see how this 256 comes, right?
Thank you, sir.
Okay. So if we take the value of this 147, still could we find the binary value for this one? Just send me that in chat. Everyone, just find the binary value of this and send me that in chat. All right, so one, no 64s, no 32s, 128 plus 16, 144, right? Again, no 8s, no 4s, 2 and 1. This is it. Right, now I want you to find minus 147. Then what you have to do? You have to take the 2's complement. Of this value. So what you have to do? 1001 0011. Initially, what you have to do? You have to find the 1's complement. So then you have to take the negative opposite side of this one. The not value. So 0 0 1 1 0 1 1 0. After that you have to add 1, then 1 0 1 1 0. So this is minus 147. So you can write the answer as minus 147 equals 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1. This is it. So every time if you are asked to find a negative value of a number, a negative number, always what you have to do, you have to take the 2's complement of the actual value, actual decimal representation. Sorry, binary representation. Or else you can, what you can do, you can just subtract 147 by 256. So this is 109, right? So then you can convert 109 into binary. That is also same. But this method is wrong, right? Make my power chikran nepala mayan. You must learn the actual procedure behind finding the minus value of minus value of the numbers. That is also possible, but this is the correct way. All Okay, right. So now we're gonna subtract numbers using this 2's complement. I think this is totally clear how you can find the 2's complement. Now what we're going to do, we're going to perform some small mathematical operations with subtraction. Let's say we have to subtract minus 13. So assume that we have to perform this one. So this is how we can do it. First, you have to find at least 227. So in this case, we have to represent these numbers with 8 digits as a byte. That is the procedure. Because normally in computer, byte is the basic or the smallest unit that's going to be processed, not a bit. Actually, bit is the smallest representation of data. Data ka represent karna smallest unit ka bit ka kya. But normally in processing, while processing, the byte is the smallest unit. Process karan samane byte ekak thamai pawichchi wenne. So we have to start from 8 bits. 128 ewa nae, 84 ewa nae, 22 ewa nae, 16 ewa ekai, 8 ewa ekai, 24, 4 ewa nae, 1, 1. Right, this is the binary representation of 27. Now we have to find the binary representation of 13. So 0, 0, 0, 16 with 0, 8 by kai, 4 by kai. Okay. Then we have to find minus 13. To find minus 13, we have to take the 2's complement of this one. So if we take first complement, that will be 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0. To find 2's complement, we have to add 1. Then 2's complement will be 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1. This is the 2's complement, that is minus 13. So now to find 27 minus 27 minus 13, what we have to do, we have to add these two values, this one and this one. So here 0 0 0 1 1 0 1 1 is 27, and the complement of 13 is this one, 1 1 1 1 0 0 1 1. We have to add these two, not OR, add. Then the answer will be, you can add these two, 0 1 1 1 again 0 0 0 0 1, right? So we're going to consider only the last 8 bits as the answer. So then if we convert this one, this is 14, right? It is correct. 27 minus 13 is 14. This is the answer. Again, this one, this is called as the carrier bit or overflow bit. Overflow bit. So we're going to ignore that overflow bit. We are going to consider only the last 8 digits of the answer. That is how we can subtract using addition by using the 2's complement. Okay, let's go with another example. This time we're going to subtract something like 135 minus 72. Now children, you can do this with me. So initially what we have to do, find 135 in binary. then that would be 128 0 0 0 128 64 32 16 8 8 1 1 1 again 72 So 72 means 0, 0, oh sorry, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0. This is it, right? At hathra yata yata the guy. Now we have to find minus 72. So then we have to take the 2's complement of that one. So that means if we take the first complement 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 1, then to find the 2's complement we have to add 1, then 0 0 0 1 1 1 0 1. Now to find 135 minus 72, we have to add these two values. So 1 0 0 0 0 1 1 1. So that is this one. And this one. (1 0 1 1 1 0 0 0) This number. We have to plus, right? Then here we have 1 1 1 1 1 1 0 0 1. Only this is considered as the answer, and this is overflow bit. This is called as overflow bit. Okay. All these are explained in the tute with examples in the note. You can further practice with that one. So I think it is clear for everyone how we can use 2's complement to subtract numbers in a binary format. Every time it is a rule that we must take the number as 8 bits as a byte. Byte එකක් විදිහට තියෙනවා නේද process කරන්න byte එකකින් byte එකමයි process වෙන්නේ. And we're going to overflow, sorry, we're going to ignore the overflow bit. Okay, children, is it clear? So if it is clear, this is all that we're going to discuss for today. Again, next day, we're going to discuss data representation, how data is going to be represented in computers. So again, we're going to discuss about binary format and the other things about how images are represented like that. So this is about logical operations in binary. So you must be able to perform 7 logical operations: AND, NOR, AND, O, NOT, NAND, NO, XOR, NXOR. So these operations with binary representations. And again, 2's complement and how to subtract using 2's complement, that should also be familiar. That also you must be familiar, right? Yes, yes, I'll upload all the lectures, but I still couldn't find a good internet connection to upload them. So this week will also not possible. sure in next week I'll upload them, right? Okay, children, do you have any question regarding things we discuss, or is clear for you? Or hamodam therunath darone hamodam puluwangana me wade karanna den. You can practice more, right? Just refer the tune and practice it that as well. Everyone should be able to perform these activities, right?
Excuse me, sir. Sir, XOR එකේ සර් මේ ආදානවල එකේ ඉලක්කම් ඔත් එක ගණක් තියෙනව නන්ද එක වෙන්නේ එහෙම
නේද නෑ නෑ XOR වල තියෙන්නේ if all the inputs are equal the output is 0 XOR
ඒක සර් මේ ඒක සර් ආදාන තුනක් ආවමත් කියන්නේ සර් කියන්නේ ආදාන තුනක් අතර කොයි වෙලාවියවත් එහෙම ගත්තොත් සර් දෙකයි නෙමෙයි එක වෙන්නේ
ඒක මෙහෙමයි වෙන්නේ දරුවෝ ඒක වෙන්නේ අපට ඉන්පුට් තුනක් ආපුවාම මෙන්න මේක මෙහෙම යක් කරනවා අපි හිතන්න අපි ලියන හොඳයි ඔය ප්‍රශ්න අපි හරිද A XOR P XOR C ඔහොමනේ වෙන්නේ මේක දැන් අර අපි AND OR කරනවා වගේ නෙමෙයි මේකෙදි වෙන්නේ අපි A XOR B ඒකෙන් එන උත්තරෙත් එක්ක XOR වෙනවා C මෙන්න මෙහෙමයි වෙන්නේ उदाहरण फिल्टर If you have three inputs, these are the all possible status combinations. Input to nakti both may tamai okkoma possible lana combinations. Sari. Ita passe apne gattot. Ana kitamu A and B and C. A and B and C. A and B and 1 ohmai yan XOR ekak e wage ne meke di wenna den me denna api XOR ekage logic e mokadda if all the inputs are equal the output is 0 thor metana idi AB tama consider karanne issala menna me me wade tama issala karanne menna meka issa thor me deka samanai samanai uttare mokadda binduwa if all are equal output is 0 again so here we going to have 0 and 0 Again, it is equal. Then output will be 0. May then samana samana in the 0. It was ekin uttare C samana in the 0. Here samana samana in the 0. Then 0 1. Asamana asamana in the 1. Again these two. These are not equal. Then output is 1 from these two. May deke output ekak 1. 1 0 again not equal then output is 1 here if you consider these two 0 1 not equal means 1 then 1 1 equal means 0. Here these two not equal means 1, 1 0 again not equal, then 0. Here not equal, therefore 1 is the output, 1 1, then these two are equal, then output is 0. 1 1 equal, so output is 0, 0 0 equal, output is 0. Again 1 1, this is equal, equal means 0, 0 1, this is not equal, then output is 1. This is how it performs. ඊට ඔක වැඩි වෙන්න වැඩි වෙන්න මොකද වෙන්නේ? ආයේ උත්තරෙත් එක්ක ආයේ x වරන. හරිද? It is very good that you asked the question පුතා මේ එක අහපේ හොඳටම හොඳයි. So that is how XOR works, right?
Thank you sir.
කර දරුවනේ truth table එක මේ study කරන්න තුනකට આવොත් හතරකට આવොත් මොකද වෙන්නේ ආයේ? මේ උත්තරෙත් එක්ක අනික XOR එක. එහෙම තමයි යන්නේ හරි? මේ මොකද මේක අපිට ඊළඟ පාඩමකදී ඕන වෙනවා මේ XOR හතන්දරේ. Okay, children, so do you have any more questions?
Adana sir, two's complement or like a kitru in one?
No,
carry bit take a negative mother.
ඒක දරුව ඇත්තම කැරී බිට් එකනේ අපි කියන්නේ ඕවර්ෆ්ලෝ බිට් කැරී බිට් කියලා ගන්න එපා ඒක ඕවර්ෆ්ලෝ බිට් හරිද කැරී බිට් කියන්නේ ඔකට වඩා වෙනස් දෙයක් අපි ඊළඟ පාඩම කතා කරනවා that is overflow bit මට කැරී බිට් කියලා කියවුණා මේ ඒ වුණාට කැරී බිට් නෙවෙයි ඕවර්ෆ්ලෝ බිට් right ඕවර්ෆ්ලෝ කියන එක අදහස් මොකද්ද අපි ටැංකියට වතුර පුරවනවා ඕවර්ෆ්ලෝ වෙනවා ඒක එලියට නෑ යන්නේ ඒ වගේ ඒකට හේතුව තමයි මෙහෙම අපි එතකොට දැන් ඕකේ අපි පාවිච්චි කරන ඇඩර් එක අර අපි නොට් කරන්න පාවිච්චි කරා වගේ ඇඩර් කියලා එකක් තියෙනවා. අපි ඉස්සරහට ඇඩර් එක කතා කරනවා මොකද්ද මේ ඇඩර් කියන්නේ කියලා. ඒකෙත් තියෙනවා ඔයාලා හිතන්න මේ devices කියලා. ඊට මෙතන input එක, output එක. input output. මොම තමයි තියෙන්නේ. එතකොට මේකට තමයි අර අනිත් ඉන්පුට් එක අපි එකතු කරන එක දෙන්නේ. මෙහෙම දුන්නම වෙන්නේ මෙයාගෙන් අරක ප්‍රොසෙස් වෙලා අපිට එනවා මොනවා හරි මේ අදාළ වැලියු එක. එතකොට මේකට අහු වෙන්නේ මේ කොනේ ඉඳන් තියෙන නම්බර්ස් 8 විතරයි. නැත්නම් bit 8 විතරයි. අනිත් bit එක මේකෙන් වෙනම ලයින් එකක් තියෙනවා. මේ channel එකෙන් අනිත් bit එක එළියට යනවා. මේක consider වෙන්නේ නැහැ. මේක කැරියර් බිට් එකක් විදිහට නෝ අපි කීප් එකක් එකතු කරනකොට ඒ කියන්නේ අපිට අපි අතන එකතු කරේ දෙකයි නැත්තරම් ගන්නකො මෙහෙම අපි මෙහෙම විතර එකතු කරේ තව එකක් තිබ්බ කියලා හිතුවොත් එතකොට මේක කන්සිඩර් කරන්න වෙනවා එතකොට ඒක දැන් මෙතන එක එකතුවක් හරිද ඔයාලා දැන් ඇඩ්‍රස් ගැන කතා කරනකොට මේක තේරෙනවා මේ දෙන්න එකතු වෙලා එකක් කැරියර් බිට් එකක් ආවොත් ඒක ආපහු ගිහලා මෙයාට ප්‍රස් වෙන අවස්ථාවක් තියෙනවා that is carry bit නැත්නම් මේක carry bit එකක් හොඳයි හිතන්නකො 0 0 0 මෙතන 1 1 1 3 3 means we gonna put 1 here and this is 1 this is called as carry bit මේ ඇඩර් එකෙන් මේ ටික එකතු වෙලා එක ආවා එකක් යනවා ඉස්සරහ that is carry bit so in two's complement what we call the overflow bit that is going to be ignored එකට මුකුත් වෙන්නේ නැහැ ඒක ignore වෙනවා
හරි සර්
හරි අපි අර ඇඩර්ස් ගැන කතා කරද්දි මේක වලට තව ක්ලියර් වෙනවා හරි ඔකේ any more questions
no sir thank you
okay so if you have no more questions we can wind up now වලට තව questions නැත්නම් අපිට wind up කරන්න පුළුවන්
සර් 135න් අර මේ 72 අඩු කරාම එන උත්තරේ මේ يعني 135 72 අඩු කරාම එන උත්තරේට සමාන වෙන්න ඕනද?
ඔව්. ඒක බයිනරිලින් අපි හොයපුවාම හිතන්නකෝ මෙහෙම දැන් අඩු කිරීමක් කරලා තියෙනවා කියලා. මේක අඩු කරපහ එන උත්තරේට අරක සමාන වෙන්න ඕන. يعني මේකමයි වෙන්නේ. මේක අපි ඩෙසිමල් වලින් කරන්නේ. කම්පියුටර් එක මේක කරන්නේ ඔක බයිනරි වලට හරවලා අර 2's complement එකට දාලා තමයි යන්නේ. එකම උත්තරේ. මෙතනින් එන හැම වෙන උත්තරේ මේකෙන් හැම වෙන උත්තරේ දෙකම සමානයි.
Excuse me, sir.
How?
Sir, I thought I'd be me Uttar Liadi, decimal level at the end.
No, I was not. While two's computer link on other than Qworth, when I binary Uttar Yaragan and Arthur. Another overflow beat thing on the ground.
Sir, I thought of me, I can see a suit on a two's complimentary in a grad. This is a panacea. I thought of this is a panacea. Vedia caught him a decimal leg at the dinner. Consider him that one.
No, that's saying. දෙක අට දාසේ එහෙම නෑනේ එතකොට දාසේ එකෙන් තමයි යන්නේ හරි ළමයි